morning everyone. Today we are going to read the lesson Our Constitution. In this we have discussed already about the framing of Constitution as well as of drafting committee. Now next we have to deal with the preambles to the Constitution. The Indian Constitution has combined in itself the best features of different constitutions of the world and has its own preambles. The preambles contains the fundamental policies and ideals of the Constitution. It is the sum of the structure, values, principles and goals of the Constitution. It is based on the aspiration and ideals of the people of India. The preamble is a part of the objective resolution put forward by Jawaharlal Nehru on December 13, 1946 and approved by Constituent Assembly on 22 January 1947. This resolution upholds the nature of Indian sovereign democratic republic as well as social and economic and political justice for all the people is upheld. First it is we have to see the preambles of Constitution. Four points are there: justice, liberty, equality and fraternity. In justice we should get the social, economic as well as the political justice. Liberty means freedom. Freedom of thought, expression and belief. Equality of status and of opportunities to promote among them all. Fraternity means universal brotherhood, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. It is fraternity. Here the preamble to our Constitution, it is meaningful. It is described our political system and it is key to understand our Constitution. It has been described as jewel of Constitution by K.M. Munshi, as well as it has also refers as political horoscope. The preamble of Constitution is also known as political horoscope. It has started, "We, the Indian citizen." The preamble of the Constitution begins, "We, the citizen of India." The Indian Constitution is framed by Indians, is strived to fulfill the dreams of Indians. In this we have to see about the four points: sovereign, socialistic, secular, democratic republic. First it is sovereign. Sovereign means India is a sovereign country and not under the control of any other country in the world. It is not a part of any bloc. It has its own foreign policies, non-alignment policies and five-year plans by implementing which the country has achieved internal and external autonomy. Autonomy means one who is free enough, independent. It is called as autonomy. Next it is socialistic. The goal of our Constitution is to create social equality and promote welfare of all the people in our country. To enable this, directive principles of state policy have been incorporated in our Constitution through the 42 amendment done in 1946. Amendment means change in constitution or law. It is called as amendment when it has adopted after the 42nd amendment in the year 1976. Though this amendment, land reforms and the other progressive economic reforms were introduced. Next it is secular. The word secular has been incorporated in the Indian Constitution through the 42nd amendment in 1976. No religion has been given the status of a national religion. So India is a secular country. Citizens have the liberty to practice any religion they desire. All religions have equal status in India. Next it is democratic republic. Securing the happiness of everyone is the responsibility of a government in a democracy. Problems are solved through decisions. Elections are held every 5 years through universal adult franchise. Universal adult franchise means after the 18 years, the adults can give their votes and elect their representative. It is called as universal adult franchise. The fact that our head of the state is the president of India, who is elected for a period of 5 years, proves that our country is a republic.